Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we're going to be creating a paint text effect inside Photoshop. We'll look at how to create a colorful paint effect and also give a single color tone to the text. We have used some new techniques to create out this design concept, so let's begin with the designing process. Open a new Photoshop document. Now we'll type our text, so press T to activate a text tool and type our text. We'll apply bold font style to the text. After that, create a duplicate of the text layer by pressing Command or Control J. Now right click and rasterize the text layer so that it becomes editable. Next, select the square brush tool and fill up the area with the same color. Then create under duplicate of the rasterized layer. Now press P for the pen tool and start drawing out a shape. Click and drag to go on with the curved shapes. So after drawing out the shape, press Command or Control Enter to make a selection. Then invert the selection area with the shortcut Command or Control Shift I and press Delete. After that, press Command or Control D to remove the selection. Now click on the layer to open the layer style panel. In that panel, switch on Gradient Overlay. Now go to Gradient Color panel and pick Magenta color. Double click on the slider to open the color picker panel. Here, pick a dark color to give a nice shade. Next, switch on the bevel and ambers, then increase the depth value, size level, and click OK. This will add a nice, soft, and moist color effect to the shape. Now, add a new layer on top. We'll use this to add depth. Now, click on thumbnail of the shape layer with the control press to make the selection. Next, press B for the brush tool and set the stroke size. Pick dark color and add some darkness at the edges. This will add some depth. Now pick the white color from the color picker panel. With this, we'll add highlights around the shape. Next, select the triangle shape layer and create under duplicate. Keep the layer on top and decrease its opacity to see the layer below it. Now we'll draw under shape over it by maintaining a distance from the first shape. So take a pen tool again and start drawing out the shape. After drawing the shape, delete the unwanted area by following the same steps. Then place the layer below the first shape and apply gradient overlay on the layer style panel. So here, as we did for the previous shapes, set some gradient shades with dark and brighter color. Then apply bevel and ambers and adjust the depth and the size for the shape. After that, open the layer style panel for the first shape and apply drop shadow. Set a distance and adjust the spacing level until we get a proper shadow effect. Now add a new layer and double click on the thumbnail of the second shape with the control press to make a selection. Then add a brushstroke highlight with a darker color. After that, take another copy of the triangle shape layer, open the layer style panel, and apply gradient overlay. Next, start creating a shape with a pen tool. Then make a selection and delete out the unwanted area. After that, open the layer style panel, apply two gradient shaded colors, and then apply bevel and ambers effect like the previous shapes. Now take a new layer and add some highlights with the brush tool. Here, check the layer placement and place it on top of the other shapes. Now take another copy of the triangle shape layer and place it on top. Then decrease the opacity level and start drawing out shape with the pen tool. After that, delete the unwanted parts. By repeating the same process, apply gradient overlay, bevel and ambers layer style, then apply brush strokes on the shapes for highlights and shadows. Next, take a copy of this triangle shape layer again and decrease its opacity level. So, repeat the same process, draw a shape with a pen tool, get the same layer style, and brush strokes, shadows and highlights to it. Then take elliptical tool and create out a circle at the center holding Alt Shift key. While creating, hold spacebar to move the shape at a particular place. Fill it up with a white color. Move the selection slightly a bit and delete the part, so that we can add an edge glow with this part. For that, edge the placement and pick the eraser tool by pressing E. Then erase the sharp edges. Next, take a copy of the layer and merge both the layers. Again take a copy, select the bottom layer, then go to Filter, Blur and apply Gaussian Blur. Edge the radius value around 4 and click OK. Now select the copied layer and apply Gaussian Blur. This time edge the radius around 1 and click OK. Then select both the layers and group them up by pressing Command or Control G. Next, take another copy of the group and place it at the bottom. Take a copy again and place it over the other shapes to give a glow effect. Now press Command or Control T to activate the transform option and rotate it. In the same way, take some more copies and edge them on the shape. To get a proper glow effect, we'll add some more darker shades on the shape. After that, select the bottom layer triangle shape and apply gradient overlay under layer style panel. Over here, apply suitable color shades matching with the other shape's color. Next, take the elliptical tool and create out a circle. Open the layer style panel and apply gradient overlay. Change the style to radial and add a color slider in the middle. Then choose some attractive color for the shape. Adjust it on top left and apply bevel and ambus. Now increase the size to merge with the shape. Take a new layer and add some highlights with a soft brush tool. Next, to add more highlights to your design, take a copy of the elliptical shape layer and place it on top. Now right click and rasterize it. After that, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Adjust the radius level around 10 and click OK. Next, open the layer style panel and apply overlay. In that, choose two brighter colors for a nice glow. Now, reverse it and click OK. Then, take the eraser tool by pressing E and erase the middle part, so we can see a glow around the circle. After that, select all the layers and group them. Name it as Text A. Similarly, we'll apply the same effect and the techniques on the other letters. So, we got a colorful text with a nice effect using the same techniques. Let's add some bubble glow effect on the text. For that, take a new layer and select the pen tool. Create out a shape between the letter A and R. After that, make a selection. Press B for the brush tool. And pick a pale pink color. And start applying the brush strokes around the shape. Then take a different brighter colors and apply them along the borders. Next, take eraser tool and erase out the lower edges part. Add highlights using the circular arc shape. Apply Gaussian blur to give soft blend. Increase the color brightness using the color overlay under layer style panel. After that, add some highlight along the edges. And here we got a nice colorful paint text effect. Next, let's add a bubble glow between alphabet R and T. So, take the pen tool and create out a shape. Then, make a selection and add some brush strokes with different colors. Erase out the end parts to merge with the background. So further, if you want to change the color saturation, simply follow this step. add a human saturation adjustment layer and decrease the saturation value so that the complete design will turn into a graystone. Next, enable colorize and choose some color. Adjust the hue levels to get different colors. We can also increase the saturation to give a nice color to the design. Next, apply curves and adjust the red, green and blue curves level on the design. Now, we'll add brightness and contrast. Increase the contrast and observe the changes. So like this, we can give an interesting style to our design. You can either give colorful or a single tone effect to your text. Finally, we have completed designing a paint text effect using Photoshop. We have used some new tools and options that have made it so easier to create out this complex design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.